Was Ron Paul right? That's going to be the subject of this video. It's February 22nd, 2010. I'm Reginald, also known as Demcad. First, the Obama health care bill looks like it's going to be $1 trillion, a 10-year deal, and it will not have the public option, but they got rid of that $100 million that was going to Nebraska because their senator, one of their senators, Ben Nelson, a Democrat, wanted about $100 million in Medicaid funding. That was what it took to really get him to support the bill, but they finally got rid of that. So they're trying to give an olive branch to the Republicans, and we're going to see if they're going to bite. I don't think they will. There's just no incentive to go along with this. They used to call this a $100 million deal the Cornhusker kickback, but I'm glad that kickback is gone. But I just don't see the Republicans supporting this bill. There's simply no incentive. It's too unpopular for them to actually support. It'd be stupid of them to support this bill. But it looks like the Louisiana Purchase, as some Republicans are calling it, the $300 million to Louisiana, is still in the bill. One of their senators, Landro, I believe that's the senator's name, she wanted the $300 million because she believed that Louisiana was underfunded when it came to disaster relief. So that's her excuse for pretty much using this deal to vote for the health care plan. Even if she is right, the fact that she's demanding $300 million or so, or the fact that somebody's offering her $300 million for a vote, raises questions about her integrity. Before I talk about Ron Paul, I want to talk about this. This is really interesting. Less than 3 out of every 20 Americans still have faith in the government. And my question is, who are these 3 people? Okay, according to a CNN Opinion Research Corporation poll, only 14% of Americans have complete faith in the United States government and the way it functions. My guess is that 14% is comatose. But seriously, I don't know who these 14% are. I mean, who are these people, really? Goldman Sachs, they're in the news again, big surprise. A top executive is saying that Goldman Sachs did nothing inappropriate when it arranged a currency swap deal, with the Greek government. And this actually helped reduce the country's national debt by about 2.37 billion euros, which is $3.2 billion. They said that, basically they didn't do anything wrong, which, now, given the type of company we're talking about, I don't really have much faith in these guys, and I'm very suspicious in just about everything they do. Ron Paul is a surprise winner of the CPAC presidential straw poll. He captured 31% of the 2,400 votes cast in the annual contest. Now, this is basically a contest that pretty much shows how well Republicans are doing in a presidential race, well, in the early parts of a presidential race. And I'm pretty surprised that Ron Paul won. He's a libertarian, and really, I heard some people were actually booing him, which isn't a surprise. This guy, he's anti-war, which, you know, is never going to go over well with Republicans or Democrats, you know. You know, I mean, it's really surprising, but the guy's too old to really be president at this point, and I think they're going to end up nominating Mitt Romney, and he's going to be the 45th president of the United States. Somebody who's even less trustworthy than Barack Obama, I think. About Ron Paul, it seems to me that he was absolutely right. He was by far the most intelligent person in a 2008 presidential campaign. He was spot on about the war. He was spot on about the economy. And it's amusing to see somebody like that be so right and still be ignored by the majority of the population here in America. So, I'm going to say it. Ron Paul was right. I should have voted for him in a Republican primary, but I didn't. Guess you can consider this to be a public apology for not voting for Ron Paul.
Okay, another beautiful Michigan morning or afternoon, whatever.
Yeah, I saw Team Canada lose in hockey to Team USA, so wow. Don't expect Canadians to lose in hockey, especially in Canada, so come on, guys. Step it up. But anyway, congratulations to Team USA. Congratulations to Tanith Belbin and Ben Augusto and Charlie White and Meryl Davis. They both skated very well. They're in second and third right now, I believe, or second and fourth. So, good luck, Meryl. Good luck, Charlie. You know, I should also congratulate Tessa Virtue and Scott Moore. They skated very well. They deserve to be in first place. They're very,
okay,
very good.
Today I'm going to be doing a radio show. I'm going to be covering several topics. One of the topics is going to be presidential politics and midterm elections. Do you think that the Tea Party should join the Republican base and try to take over the Republican Party? Or do you think that we're going to need a third party? Or do you believe that the system can't really be salvaged at all? And I'm also going to take some economic updates and reports from you guys so you can call in and tell me what's going on in your area. I'll tell you guys what's going on in my area. So I hope to talk to you guys on Freedomizer Radio. The link is right in my description box. All right, bye.